In this video, you will learn what Shamir Secret Sharing is and how it can drastically increase the security of your crypto. You'll also learn why this is superior to homemade methods such as splitting your seed phrase into a 2 out of 3 system. So, why would you want to do that? Because your seed phrase represents a single point of failure.
A precise hit will start a chain reaction which should destroy the station.
If it gets stolen, an attacker now has your funds. Or if you lose it, you are denied access to those funds. So how can you store your seed phrase in a more secure, robust, and distributed way? Should you scramble it, encrypt it, store it out of order, split it, do a 2 out of 3 system? The problem with most of these systems is they come from self-appointed experts. Watching a lot of football doesn't make you an offensive coordinator, and using crypto doesn't make you a cryptographer. So rather than listening to me or some other random internet opinion, you should listen to Adi Shamir. Adi Shamir is an Israeli cryptographer who came up with SSS, or Shamir Secret Sharing Scheme, and it is the only truly cryptographically safe way to store your seed phrase in a distributed way. Before we talk about SSS though, how it works and how to do it, it's worth talking about the homemade version of SSS, the 2 out of 3 method. This is the method you will probably run into most frequently in online forums. Here's how it works. You split your 24 seed phrase into 3 parts, part A, B, and C. Then you recombine each part into 3 shared units, unit AB, BC, and AC. Since each unit only has 16 of the 24 words, any one part is not enough to steal your seed phrase. But if you combine any 2 of the 3 units, you get your full 24 words again. It's an honest attempt at trying to get around the single point of failure, but please don't do this. Your gut response might be to think that it reduces your security by 2/3 since you reduce 24 random words to only 8 random words. But because you're choosing from a list of 2,048 words 24 different times versus only 8 times, it's actually trillions of times worse. A random set of 24 words is considered 256 bits of security. A random set of only 8 words is considered only 80 bits of security. So even though 80 bits is way worse than 256 bits, is 80 bits of security still good enough? People online argue about this a lot. Some people say it is, and some people say it isn't. Just Google 80-bit security if you want to go down that rabbit hole. But the point I'm making is that you don't have to settle for 80 bits of security when instead you could keep all 256 bits of security and still get the flexibility offered by seed splitting. It's called Shamir Secret Sharing Scheme. Adi Shamir, the man who came up with SSS, also helped come up with RSA encryption. The S in RSA stands for Shamir, so he's a pretty big deal. SSS allows you to split your secret phrase into as many parts as you'd like without revealing any information to anyone until they gather enough parts to meet the threshold. First, you decide how many parts you want to split your seed phrase into, called shares. And then you decide how many shares will be required to recover the seed, called the threshold. A share, like you are used to with a regular seed phrase, is just a list of words. But rather than using the BIP39 word list and being 24 words long, it uses the SLIP39 word list and is usually 20 words long for each share. So if you split it up into 6 shares and you decide you need 3 to recover it, then the threshold is 3. If an attacker is lucky enough to get his hands on only 2 parts, then they still don't have any information about your seed phrase because the shares don't give away any information until the full threshold is reached. This is the brilliantly amazing part of the Shamir sharing scheme. If you don't have the full threshold, you don't have anything. Even if you were just 1 share off from the threshold, an attacker would still have to brute force the full 256 bits of security. But how does that work? To be honest, the math involved is way out of my league, but I'll do my best to explain a simplified version. It all comes down to math and polynomials. Let's say your secret recovery phrase was represented by a curvy line on a graph, a mathematical function called a polynomial. In this example, to know 100% what the equation of that line is, we need to have 3 data points. But what if we erase one of the data points? Can we draw our line? Unfortunately, we can't, because we end up being able to draw an infinite number of solutions for lines that go through those 2 dots. So we are just left with guessing through an infinite number of possibilities. It's not until we get the 3rd data point where we can successfully recover the equation for our line. And with our 3rd data point, we can solve for our equation and recover the keys to our account. Without the full threshold of points, an attacker has an infinite number of solutions, and therefore, the information is useless. This is what makes the Shamir secret sharing scheme so powerful. You choose the number of shares you want, then you choose how many data points are required to be able to recover your account. This not only protects you from attackers, but it also protects you if you lose a couple of shares. Right now, if you want to use SSS, it's only compatible with Trezor and Keystone. I've read about several hardware wallets with plans to implement it in the future, and when they do, I'll let you guys know in the comments. I really hope more hardware wallets implement it in the future because it's incredibly powerful. Even after watching this whole video, though, you might just decide that SSS isn't for you, and that's okay. The best protection is the one that you understand and can implement the best. So if you're not confident you could set it up and recover it correctly, it's better not to use it in the first place.